Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to my summer car. Yeah, before I go to bed, which I was gonna do just before saving, there's one thing I forgot. I brought home a bunch of fireworks. It's down at the boat, isn't it? Yeah, I brought home a bunch of fireworks. And I promised to launch it for you. So I'm gonna do that while it's still dark. It's around midnight in game time. I think it's still down here by the boat. Coffee mug is here. Let's empty this bag. Oh, that's a lot of fireworks. It would maybe have been a better idea to bring the bag up and find some place around the house to launch it. Wow, that's a lot of fireworks. Alright, that's a lot of fireworks. Okay. Can I launch it while holding it? Yeah. Where did it go? Okay, I have a better idea. Quit the menu, and then reload, and then actually do what I should have done, which is just bring the bag of fireworks up to the house. Because sending them all one by one just took too long. Yeah, it's midnight. Gotta get my fireworks up before it's too late. I don't need a flashlight. I think. Yeah, next time I'm down there, I'm gonna bring the coffee mug. I don't have any coffee at the house now anyway. I need to go and buy that at the store. So the mug and kettle can just stay on the beach for the time being. Right, and now I might actually need that flashlight. do I take the lid off? Ah. I hope this will not destroy the bucket. Because I need that one for moonshine. Can I empty them directly into? Uh-oh. Accidentally lit one on fire. Oops. Could have gone a lot worse. So the plan is to be able to light as many rockets at once as possible. I wonder if that fireworks bag is like infinite fireworks. Because seem to be no end of the amount of rockets that came out. These types of rockets are banned now. They were banned a few years ago. At least in Norway. They have been banned in Sweden now too. After they were banned in Norway, we used to be able to go to Sweden and buy. Did I light one? No. And buy them. The border. Don't know where that went. Kind of hard to find the exact spot you have to hover over to light them. Uh-oh. And last one. Alright, I don't think I burnt my house down. Let's go to bed. Actually, first, don't want to be awakened by that drunk guy. I found out you can actually unplug your phone. And then remember to plug it back in. A piss. And then we're gonna start working on the car. Yeah, I'm sorry, I didn't buy any mosquito spray. Gotta just have to bear with me. Uncle's blue van is nowhere to be seen today. So, where were we in regards to the car? Guess I can put the steering rack in. Where's my toolkit? And let's see, 8 millimeter. Try that first. Nine. Yeah. And then the steering column. This is stuff that's gonna be hard to attach once the engine is in. Try 8 millimeters first. Yeah. And then the steering rods will have to wait until after I have the axles in. Let's get the I guess I need guess I need the engine in first to install the clutch. I mean the clutch master cylinder. Let's just put that there. Because the transmission is on the engine. But I can do the brakes. Probably nice to have the handbrake in and have the brakes sorted before installing the engine, so I can put the handbrake on and stop the car from rolling around a whole bunch. Brake lining. Why can't I crouch here? There you go. Much easier to get to without the engine in the way. Oh, bless me. Oh, GT steering wheel. I wanna put that in. Is that a 14? Of course, the steering wheel doesn't do anything at the moment. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Brake pedal. That was an 8mm. Now let's get the handbrake. Oh, come on. If I grab it here, it will probably be easier, yes. I'm gonna guess 6mm. Nope. 7. 8. Yeah. Now let's carefully position the car so I can push it inside. Maybe adding those, yeah, I think I need those steering rods just to keep the wheels straight. So I can push it inside. Let's mount the engine to the hoist first. Which you need to do to install the engine. Even though you can clearly lift it by hand. Doing. It's this way. There we go, got a bolt there. Close enough. Close enough. Let's try 10. Oh, yeah. Okay, shift. No, steering rods, I mean. Front right. I saw the check mark. Because right now I can't push the car because the wheels just turn all over the place. I had the check mark, come on. Be like this. Try 11. Let's try 12. Yeah. There we go. This guy gonna be difficult too. Sometimes it's so sensitive, it has to be like in the exact right spot. Try mounting it from inside. Yeah, Yeah, that works. And that's the one you adjust. Like your alignment with. Let's push it sidewards a little bit. I do not want it falling into the trench. Like you see it's about to do here. Yeah, I can tell the alignment is off. But I can adjust on that later. Oops, too far. Careful nudges. Actually, that's perfect. That is perfect. Oh yeah, I was supposed to hook up the brakes so I can apply the handbrake. That's what I was gonna do. That's the rear brake, like proportioning valve. And that's the handbrake cable. I think it was a 5mm to attach the cable. Yeah. Now, should have a working handbrake. Yes. Yes, yes. So if I now try to push the car, it's not gonna roll. I can still push it, because physics. but it will be way more controlled than if I didn't have the handbrake. I need the engine lined up with at least one of the engine mounts, like that. And let's try a 10mm first. Nope. And once I have one bolt in, the other ones will just line up automatically. 11, yes. There. Got that satisfying chunk. Now then, let's unhook the engine from the hoist. And move the car back outside. Who's this? Okay, my order has arrived. Don't think I have enough money. And at the moment, I only have the slow tractor. Release the parking brake. And then reapply it. Now, let's get the jack, get the car jacked up, and install the drive shafts that I struggled with like crazy the first time. But now I know what to do, so it shouldn't be too difficult. See, 13mm for the wheels. My guy needs a smoke. And the macaroni dinner. There we go, and some water. Gonna save the beer for when I'm out and about. No blue van outside Uncle's house. Now 11 millimeter for or was it 12? Yeah. And a 14 here. And the half shaft should just pop into place like that. Remember how much I struggled trying to get that in the first time when I didn't know I had to remove the steering rods? It's a bit easier when you've done it before. Then pop the steering rod back in, which I had hoped would not be difficult. Then just reattach the wheel. Why can't I just get the same shade of green at the shop? It's annoying me. Gonna buy some black paint next time I'm at the store. Need to loosen that one too, of course. There we go. And yeah, like that. Alright, alright. Let's get the air cleaner mounted. In case it starts raining. I'm not sure if that's like modeled in the game, but shouldn't leave the carburetor open to the elements. See what now? Clutch. There we go. And 7 millimeters to tighten the linings. Ah, I need to get the linings. And I left them here. Clutch lining. So the check mark. Let's see. This one to the clutch master cylinder. Goes into here. Have I not tightened that one? No. Oh. Okay, okay. Now let's get the fuel tank and fuel line in. Gonna do that from underneath. And also the shift linkages and stuff like that. Right. Give it a little push here. Let's see. Shifter. Where is it? Here it is. Gear stick. And yeah, those were 6 millimeters. That's what I have currently. There we go. Let's find the right tool. They are tiny, could they be 5? Yeah. I'll have to look it over from above and see if I missed anything. Guessing 7. Try 6 first. Okay, let's try 8. Okay, let's try 10. Oh, they're not that big. Start from the bottom. Work our way up. Millimeter? Really? Fuel hose needs tightening. It's probably even bigger. Yeah, 12. Okay, fuel tank is in. Fuel tank pipe. Trunk. It did not need any tightening. Let's see, exhaust. This one is rather finicky. Come on, I know it goes in like this. I saw something. This exhaust pipe living a life of its own. I just want to grab it somehow. really should be a little bit more forgiving with where you have to point your mouse to get that check mark. I saw it here. There we go. And 7 millimeters on the exhaust flange. And I think it was a 5 millimeter on the hanger, maybe, okay, maybe 6. Okay, maybe 7 there too. All right, exhaust is in. Probably the most annoying part. Don't troll me like that. There we go. And that's a 7 millimeter too. All right. That should be it underneath the car. I think. It's getting dark, so I'm gonna just keep it in the garage. So I can work late. Couple of bolts here I had not tightened. That's probably a 5 millimeter. Yeah. That's probably a 7. Try 6. It's probably bigger. It looks loose. There we go. See. Alternator. I hope this one is not broken. Or nearly broken. That nut is probably one size bigger. Okay, maybe not. There we go. All right. Electrics. There we go. Probably six. Okay, seven. Eight, yes. Now, radiator. Actually, first, fuel strainer. There we go. That's an 8mm too. Now, radiator. Also 8mm. Let's try 6. Try 7. Yeah. And horses. Need a screwdriver to tighten the hose clamps. One looks like it goes here. Yep. And last one is here. I can just position it correctly. There we go. All right. Dashboard. I'm gonna get this the last stuff here bolted in. Then I can do electrics tomorrow. Do I need to have the steering wheel out to mount the dashboard? Maybe. No, I just need to have the dashboard itself first, of course. Just bring that here. And these are 10mm nuts. These are 6mm bolts. Any like hidden bolts behind here? Aha! Good thing I spotted that one. or I would be driving without a clutch. Let's go through them all. Nine. Get the clock. The RPM gauge I ordered goes on the steering column. So I can keep the clock in the car. And actually having a clock is super useful in this game. Okay, let's get this taken out. My new oil filter. Let's get a drink of water. Quick shower, because these flies are actually starting to bug me. No pun intended. What was I doing? Yeah. Engine oil. Coolant. Brake fluid. I'm gonna do the fluids first thing tomorrow, because that will be just after a save. And what I'm thinking is, if I have messed up and left something untightened and all my fluids just run through and out on the floor, then I can just load and I won't have to go to the store and buy more. So, fluids first, then electrics. You didn't I don't think you got to see me do the electrics in season 3 because I was accidentally not recording those episodes. Just take a puff of smoke. Before bed. To get the stress down. A quick piss and a save. And then I just have to go to bed when I reload the save to the next episode. But that's it for now. Good night and take care.